It is my experience that there is no such thing as the truth. We can never find the truth that is true for everybody. We can have a truth and a perception of reality that resonates with our heart. But in my experience, I've never seen a truth that can change. Sometimes through your different experiences in life, your truth changes. The way you look at the world changes. So when somebody else says something, it can mean that that is something that is true for them, but it doesn't have to be true for you. So I'm not trying in my work and in my life to convince people of what the truth is or what we should be doing in life. It's about me giving options and opening your awareness to finding that truth, what is in your heart, what resonates with your truth and with who you are. And that's all I hope to do, to awaken something within you that says, I don't believe this or I do believe this. Because if you listen to something I say or anybody says, and within your heart you can feel, I totally do not believe this, and that's perfect. That's perfect, as long as your true body is resonating with it and it's not out of fear for change. Energies I work with are not from this three-dimensional world, and or actually I could say the energies that work through me, that's a better description of it. These energies come from a place where there's more influences than are present in duality. So in our experience of the world, or the experience of most people in this world, is that there's two opposites, plus and minus, and they're working together. Some moments, plus is this way and this is minus, and we're constantly attracting and pulling against something. And these beings have taught me there's a reality where there's not two energies, but actually more than two energies, which is a trinity, not duality, but triality or a trinity. And it gives a whole different look on life. Because we're so stuck in this push and pull constantly, and that keeps us stuck in a circle, or the experience of a circle, which is never a circle, it's a spiral. So even though you think you're going in the same circle over and over again, it's not true. You're in a spiral, and you're going somewhere. Something is changing within you. Something is changing, but it takes your awareness to see that something is happening, that it's not all stagnant, that nothing is the same. No sunrise is the same. Nothing is the same as it was yesterday. So duality is just a perception of reality. It isn't the truth. And when you look at triality or the Trinity, you start looking beyond right and wrong. And if you look beyond right and wrong, there's a whole world in which it doesn't exist. There is no right and wrong. The way they explained it to me is that you can look at it as a magnet, that there's no right and wrong. They said if you have two strong magnets, one, it has two poles, plus and minus, and the other one has a pole too, plus and minus. Now if two poles, the plus poles, try to push against each other, you will feel that there's a repellent, there's something that doesn't want to go forward. Because in essence, life and the magnets want to put the plus and the minus together. Then there's a flow of energy. That's when the field comes forward. So when these two energies try to collide, which can never happen, you feel this huge resistance. And this resistance is what we feel when we're doing something that's not in resonance with who we are. Then we feel this energy going, this doesn't feel right. But we can't explain it with our minds. Our minds don't understand this concept. So we're still trying to push and say, no, I have to do this, I have to go here. And while these poles of these magnets are going, it's impossible. There's no match, there's no flow in this energy. So when we think things clash because we didn't listen to our hearts, they don't clash. One pole will turn around and the minus pole will attract the plus pole, because the plus and the plus, or the minus and the minus, can never get together. They will always switch around making a flow of energy again. So in that concept, they explained to me there is no right and wrong. It will always turn around as something that works. So think of all the bad experiences you've had in your life, the moments where you think, oh my God, did that happen to me? Why did I do that? And then look back at what it's brought you, what it's taught you. That is the ultimate flow of energy that always happens. So I've learned from that there is no right and wrong, and it doesn't stop me from experiencing things as me being wrong or doing things wrong, but I know in my heart, and I always look back and go, okay, I know, there is no right and wrong. It's just my perception.